வணக்கம், வெல்கம் டு கலப்பை சேனல். இந்த வீடியோ பாருங்கள், லைக் பண்ணுங்கள், ஷேர் பண்ணுங்கள், மறக்காமல் சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணுங்கள். வணக்கம், ஐ எம் பாஸ்கரன் கிருஷ்ணமூர்த்தி, ஃபார்மர் பப்ளிக் ரிலேஷன் ஆஃபீஸர், இன்கம் டேக்ஸ் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட், சென்னை. இன்கம் டேக்ஸ் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் இஸ் கிவிங் யூ மணி, கைண்ட்லி சென்ட் தீஸ் டீடைல்ஸ். மெனி பீப்புள் மெட் ஹவ் ரிசீவ்டு மெயில்ஸ் ஆர் மெசேஜஸ் டு திஸ் எஃபெக்ட். Unfortunately, they are fake, they are bogus. Now you can see the entire message is in capital letters. We have to understand that no government communication is sent in capital letters in full. Nobody does it. In fact, even from private companies, we don't receive any communication which is fully in capital letters. So this is bogus. Second, it starts with Dear Mister. As you all know, no government communication is really so personal, so informal. It would normally start like you are hereby informed or you are hereby directed, you are hereby requested, like this. So there will not be so much of a personal touch in any government communication, so this is fake. And number three, they say request to follow and they have given a link, an external link. No government department will ask you to go to any link other than their official website. So this is bogus. Never entertain any such claim, you know, never entertain any such message. Government department will never ask you to go to some other external link and, you know, provide some details. It will not be done. This is number three. And fourth, towards the end, it says accumulated excess over the years. It has never been the case in income tax department. Suppose you have a refund for 2 years, say for 2008-09 and 2009-10. Then the refunds will be issued separately for each assessment year. Separately. It is never accumulated, it is never combined. It will be separate refund orders. And apart from all these things, whenever there is a refund which is due to you, it will be directly granted and credited to your account. They will not ask for your request, they will not ask for your approval, they will not ask you to do so, you know, send a request. No, it is not there, it is not in practice. Most importantly, this is most important. Income tax department never calls for any personal details from anyone, from any taxpayer. Income tax department would never ask for the details of debit card, credit card, PIN, password, Aadhaar card number, nothing. Income tax department never asks for any of these things. It is the taxpayer's duty to file all these things on his own, on her own. She can go to their, you know, he or she can go to their account from the official website. Against his or her PAN, and then they can file the details. So income tax department never calls for. And of course we know the official website also, it is given there, the link is given there. Let us see how the original assessment order would. We have seen the fake one. Now let us see the original one. Order under section 143(1) assessment order. It is coming from centralized processing center, Bangalore. Below that, kindly note, they have given the toll-free phone number. This is very important. They are giving you the toll-free phone number. Next to that, they give the name and address. Of course, you can know that in the next line, you can see the assessment year and PAN. So this is the format. After this, you can see there are two columns. Amount claimed by the taxpayer as it is, you know, in the return filed. And then there is another column which says as it is assessed under section 143(1)(a). So you can always compare how much taxpayer has, how much as a taxpayer you have claimed and how much it is there in the assessment order as it is assessed. So it goes in, it runs into three pages. On the third page, this last page, there is column number 53. It gives you the amount refundable. Amount refundable after adjusting any demand for the earlier years. This is the amount that is to be credited into your account against this particular assessment year. So this is it. Now you can see there is nothing very, there is nothing personal there. There is nothing informal. So it's a standardized format. Of course, there is another another order under section 154 would be more or less like on the same lines. So kindly keep it in mind. Income tax department never calls for any personal details. They never ask you to go to any external link and give your details. So kindly be aware of all these things. Let us not disclose any personal details to anyone. It is not there. So kindly be very careful. So I wish nobody allows the mischievous to take advantage of it. since this is a COVID situation where actually when nobody would be available in Income Tax Department, many people are trying to exploit the situation. Kindly beware and let us not disclose any information to anyone. And let us keep it in mind, Income Tax Department never ever calls for any personal details. All the best.